So, which tools I should focus on? IDA Pro or Ori Debugger and X64 Debugger, Immunity Debugger, or all these tools alike? Here in this video, I don't want to talk about static analysis completely and dynamic analysis. Of course, both of them are really important in your analysis. Dynamic analysis could be really important for decrypting functions and decrypting parts of the code, strings, unpacking the malware, and so many other things. And static analysis is really important to see different paths the malware may have gone through and maybe you have missed in your dynamic analysis. However, here I want to talk about something really important about the tools, especially IDA Pro. With IDA Pro, IDA Pro is not just a tool for static analysis. It is basically a documentation tool. It is the way to document your progress with the malware, renaming functions and variables, even the internal structures that the malware is using. Let's say the attacker is sending a message to the malware in a specific structure. The comment is like the first 3 bytes, then the first parameter, then the second parameter, and so on. This internal structure is getting sent to the malware, and the malware is dealing with that structure in every instruction of the code and every function it deals with something. You can document all of that in IDA Pro. You can actually document how the structure looks like and how these instructions are communicating and dealing with that structure. And so many other things you can actually document inside IDA Pro on the IDB file. This IDB file represents all the progress that you have made in analyzing this malware. You can use it to cooperate with other people in the team. You can give them this IDB file. They can continue from where you stopped, from where you finished, so they don't have to repeat the code. Imagine doing that with Ori Debugger, for example. With Ori Debugger, you will mostly rely on taking snapshots, revert back to snapshot, all of the renames or the labels that you have wrote in Ori Debugger will all be gone when you revert back a snapshot, right? And you will not be able to share all your VM with somebody else to revert to snapshots and continue from where you stopped. If you want to return back to something you may have missed earlier in the malware, either you revert back to a snapshot, or if you don't have a snapshot, you will have to reanalyze the malware again from zero. But in IDA Pro, you have all the analysis there in front of you. Of course, you will need dynamic analysis, you need static analysis. There are some cases where IDA Pro can't really help you, like really, really encrypted malware, and you have to go through different levels of decryption and so on. Maybe IDA Pro is not the best option. However, for most of the malwares and for the most of samples you will deal with, IDA Pro could be really helpful and will actually be very useful for you to rely on documenting everything in IDA Pro. Not only that, you can share it with your team, either through the cloud, like CrowdRE, which is created by CrowdStrike, or other tools that are open source and free to actually cooperate different, cooperate with the team through the cloud. But also, IDA Pro helps you to compare different variants of the same malware. Let's say after 1 year, another sample appeared from the same malware, but it's a little bit different. The encryption is different. Maybe there's added some functionality, some comments have been removed, and so on. You need to compare this to the previous sample. All the functions that are common between them, you can actually share all of this information from one malware to another. All the name of the functions, all the variable names, all the structures, if they are still the same in the next variant. And the things that are different, you can start digging inside them. But if you don't have your documentation of the malware, you are like using you will have to re-reverse this sample again from zero. Totally from the beginning. You may have some screenshots from Ori Debugger, but it wouldn't help you a lot. And your snapshots wouldn't help you at all, right? Think about it this way. If you write a software, you have a great documentation, but with this documentation that you have wrote, it doesn't it doesn't cover the source code. Like, you can't just delete the source code and say, okay, I have the documentation of the software, I will just delete all the source code. You can't do that, right? The same, you have all the Mallranas report, but you can't delete the IDB file because you may need it again if you want to analyze a new variant or you want to share this code with somebody else to continue in that manner. So that's it for this video, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.